Quickly going to pull out some of the elements of this story structure. Follows the pattern, as we'll see in a second. Let's go over basic story architecture first. So when you first start writing a filmmaking, you have a linear perspective in that sense. Pretty soon you realize that both the beginning and the ending are the same, which is why we demonstrate story structure via a loop. We identify the classic beginning and ending as a set of affection, which is the loss becomes a set of imperfection, the loss phase, or the limitations phase, and the process of returning to it is undergone. You can start there or somewhere in between. If you do that, the events there tend to be referenced at later stages, such as in this story. Most stories, such as this one, end with some form of set of affection. If you don't want to do that, if you want to end with imperfection or some combination, that's almost irrelevant. The process is always the same. So you're always going to have transformation, change, metamorphosis, transmogrification, the various arcs, psychological journey. You're always going to have physical journey, and you're always moving through new worlds, which really are physical manifestations, new psychological states, and new versions of the self. Working your way around the cycle involves jumping through lots of hoops. Each hoop has its own set of sub-stages, which in essence are functions which may be performed, messages which may be communicated. They tell you how to construct those sequences. So for example, if that's the ordinary world, we know it's a state of protection, repression, fear of exit, etc. So those sub-stages show you how to construct those sequences. When you're here, you're not able to return. You have to go forward, grow, learn, mature, lose your limitations. In essence, lose versions of your older self, come all the way around until you're ready to a return. So that's basic story architecture. It's the fundamental framework all successful stories are based around. I go over that in great detail in the 2100 stage of journey, transformation, movement through new worlds and states, which you can purchase off the website. So let's get rid of that. Let's draw in another loop. So we know now there's much more behind that than a simple circle would suggest. So the state of perfection has been lost. So from Kroll's point of view, he was part of the Federation. He was a believer. He did belong, but then he feels that the Federation abandoned him, and he lost that belief, and he didn't belong. And in essence, he turned from believing in the principles that the Federation stands for to the opposite side, in essence, believing in individualism and needing to struggle to survive. When we come into it, we meet Kirk, and the first scene is him on his own, and he's presenting this artifact, which is obviously the object of the quest that we're going to undergo. So that's immediately introduced, and he's trying to give it to this alien species. They take offense and they attack him, and they are much smaller, but together they are strong. And that first scene references one of the underlying messages of the story, which is expressed by Scotty here when he tells Jayla that you can't break a stick if it's in a bundle. So the idea of unity, we're stronger together, as opposed to alone. So we've got that as a core message. Then we've got Kirk going back onto the starship, and even though they're on this wondrous mission exploring the galaxy, etc., the fun has been lost and the wonder has been lost. So what we have is fun and wonder lost, and what we're going to do is we're going to go round through the process of rediscovering that fun and that wonder. And one of the symbols of that is the motorbike, which Kirk finds at the stage of seizing the sword. We've also got a scene where he's having a drink with McCoy, and it's on close to his birthday. Birthdays tend to mark auspicious occasions, and the journey tends to progress on an auspicious occasion. We've got Kirk saying that he always wanted to be like his father, but McCoy suggesting, acting a bit like off a supernatural aid here, suggesting that, yes, you wanted to be like your father, but what about trying to find out who you are? So that's one of the classic arcs, and what we're going to do is we're going to go around and we'll find out, the protagonist is going to go around and find out who he is. His father used to believe in the Federation, believe in the principles that it stood for, and Kirk has lost his belief and he's lost his faith. Not unlike at this stage, Krull. And what we're going to do is going to go around and he's going to rediscover his belief and his belonging and his faith. So then we come out of that, we in essence come out of the devolved state, come out of the ordinary state, we're going towards Yorktown. Yorktown is an opposite world, it's a world of unity, it's a world of happiness, and when our crew arrive there, in essence they do not belong. They're individualist. We've got Uhura breaking up with Spock, for example. We've got Kirk has applied to become an admiral, in other words, giving up his captainship. So he's going, in essence, to leave. And Spock also, following his father figure, the original Spock, is planning to leave. So not belonging, not believing, in essence, the principles of the positive side of the message that's being introduced. So then we have our alien acting as a supernatural function, coming, telling us the story of her, the loss of her ship, and is going to drag us, pull us towards the first threshold and beyond, where we're going to turn around, in essence. So we go in at the stage of when we, in essence, enter the nebula. We see the planet in the distance, a classic new world, we are attacked by the forces of Krull. And the swarm there attacks, and again, the swarm is made up of little itty-bitty ships on their own. They do no damage, but together, as a product of unity, they are strong. So again, demonstrative of the lesson that is made explicit by Scotty at that later stage. So classic things happening here. Normally you lose the attachments that represent the older self, and we've got the Enterprise, which represents the older state, the devolved state, literally dissolving away, being torn apart. We're going in the first threshold. We've got a first threshold tangible, which is obviously the artifact which we're trying to acquire. And the first threshold separation is really when we start to turn around and acting in a way that conforms to the positive side of the message. So that's when Kirk, he asks one of his crew members to help him. They all start helping each other, and that prevents Krull from getting the artifact, and in essence saves most of their lives. And we go down into the belly of the whale, where ultimately our attachment is completely lost. We're in the world of the opposite choice from Krull's world, we're all separated, which is conforming to the, in essence, anti-argument, which is individualism. And we're going to come back round and, in essence, become a unit again, unify, and then become a complete family. So physical separation when we land, and we in essence start helping each other, and then moving around towards a deeper change. So we've got McCoy helping Spock. We've got Uhura has helped Kirk already. We've got Chekhov helping Kirk, and we've got Scotty meeting Jayla, and Jayla says it really. She says, "You help me, I help you," and that in essence is the beginning of us turning around. Jayla, new character, here she's an individual, here she's alone, classic, and then we come around and at this stage she belongs, she's part of the team, and then ultimately part of the family. We're going towards our, in essence, our own trials, where we are through a product of the message going to reverse around. We've got Jayla taking us to our new home, which is going to be the USS Franklin. We've got Kirk going back to the Enterprise with the help of Chekhov, finding the location of the Cult HQ, which is going to lead us to the, in essence, the atonement, and we've got the identification and then revealing of the shapeshifter. So our supernatural agent in this story is a shapeshifter, and we separate from that here, and she dies, and death being symbolic of losing the older self, similar to the loss of the attachment. And we go into our monster's cave. Again, Uhura and Sulu have been helping each other, and they've gotten out of their cage, so to speak, and they find out that Krull has been monitoring them, and he reveals that he's going to destroy the Yorktown and the Federation, and that points us to our final conflict. And then in the monster's cave, we find, in essence, the anti, well, the essence of the antithesis, which is him not unifying, but sapping the energies of others, killing others, so that he can be strong. So the epitome of the anti-message. Going all the way around to our Season of the Tangible Sword stage, all of the things that are make us not whole here are rediscovered here. And so this is a milestone towards that. So here the fun has been lost, and here we got Kirk discovering the motorbike, and so a symbol of fun and wonder again. We've got our crew acting positively, unifying to find out where the crew is, again pointing us towards the atonement, and Krull himself, the object of the quest is located, he relocates the artifact. Then we go into our underworld phases. There's fear of going into the underworld, so and fear in essence of going towards the atonement battle, and that's expressed by Jayla, who says that Manus killed her father, anybody who goes there dies, and that's a classic function of the underworld. You go there, the old self dies, and the new self is reborn. We've got Scotty saying, or making explicit, the lesson, and Jella accepting it, so you can only break a stick if it's in a bundle. Jella asks Kirk whether he believes that, and he does. So this is where the belief is rediscovered. And then, in essence, we've got the near-death experience, which is Carl showing the product of this artifact, which is killing one of the crew members, and ultimately leading us to the atonement battle, and the boon being everybody coming together, working together, a symptom of the message, working together to to come together, and in essence to be able to develop the capacity to escape the monster's world. Leaving it, we've got a refusal to return, and then overcoming the refusal. So this is our new starship, the USS Franklin. So kickstarting that, diving to get out of that, we go through our final sequence, which is taking out the swarm, and then our final conflict, our hand-to-hand battle, and the completion essence of the arc. So here, Kirk didn't know who he was, and here we find out who you are. So that is Krull saying, at least I know who I am, and Kirk's saying, well, I know who I am too, and it's to be alive and it's to help save people, which is the opposite of what you're doing. And then coming all the way around, and it's those final scenes where, in essence, we reverse from here, we're in our original position there, to our reverse position, and whereas here we had lost the wonder and the fun, so that's been rediscovered as a part of the journey. Whereas here we were individualistic and alone. Here we're part and parcel, in essence, of the family. Jayla was an individual here. Here she's become a member of the family. Here they didn't believe in the principles of the Federation, in essence, unity. Here they're all getting together. It's the expression of that. Here they didn't belong, in essence, in Yorktown, the expression of what the Federation stands for. And here at the end, they all do belong. So that's a very basic breakdown of that story structure. If you want a detailed deconstruction, you can order it off the website. Once again, showing you that all these stories follow this process of journey and change and transformation, which as I said, I go into in great detail in the 2100 Stage of Journey Transformation, Movement Through New Worlds and States, which you can purchase off the website.